Creators, welcome to DaVinci Resolve Over 40 in 30, day 18. And today we're going to get into another quick podcast edit. This time we're going to test out the AI feature that is in DaVinci Resolve Studio. I know some of you guys don't have Studio, and maybe one day this will make it to the regular version, but it's just to give you an idea of what it does, because you can decide then if it's worth getting Studio. Anyway, so just a quick recap what we did yesterday. So I recorded a podcast in Ecamm. And because of the way Ecamm has their thing set up, there are other programs that do this as well. I just use Ecamm because, well, I work there. So let me pop into this real quick so you can see. I recorded using my camera here you see in the front as the master camera, and you select the audio source as the primary mic. I had Mr. Camera Junkie Luis as my interview guest, and I selected the guest audio. And because I'm using record all broadcasts and I'm having the isolated files recorded with these two checkboxes, I get basically a video source of him and his microphone as a source, a video source of myself and a microphone as a source. And I also get whatever is shown here in the master window that shows up. So what it looks like once we are done recording, again, is the Zoom active speaker. I don't need that for this particular section. But there is my source, right? There is Mr. Camera Junkie Luis's source. And then there is the interview as we saw it in Ecamm. And if
you want to swear in,
pause that real quick, jump that there. It looks like this when you're in sort of the interview, actual interview section. Okay. So we're going to leave these here so that we can grab them in a second once we pop open the DaVinci Resolve, and then we will bring up Resolve to the front right about now. Give this guy a second to load. Now, what's really cool about doing this multicam project, I'll go ahead and bring up what we started yesterday here. And then I made a new timeline called AI Cut. And again, to create a new timeline, all you need to do is go here, right click, new timeline, say create a new timeline, right? AI podcast cut demo, right? That's all you got to do, right? And I have this track set to stereo, empty timeline. Of course, you can always click this if you need to modify the settings, but for my setup, I don't need to do that. So go ahead and press create and then double click this timeline to make that active. Now, all I did was take this multicam clip that I have here and drag it down to the timeline. Simple as pie. Okay. We can increase our audio here. You can grab this bottom piece, draw the audio file a little bigger, and then I'll increase our visual so that we can see. I know that we start right here at the clap. So what I'll do first is Command B to slice that up. And then I'll Shift Delete to get rid of that. Now, what I'm going to do is highlight my multicam file, double click it to highlight it in the viewer. And then you have to absolutely make sure, you notice there's no icon here. You have to click this guy and make sure you put it on multicam. And now that it's on multicam, I have a button here. Right, and it highlights whenever I hover over top of it. I am going to be doing video only. I don't know if that makes a difference for this, but we're going to click it anyway. And then I'm going to back out so you can see. I'm going to press this button, and we're going to get this window. So let's embiggen this. And you see minimum edit duration. We'll call it 1 second. Edit change delay. If you needed to do anything there, you can adjust that. Automatically detect wide angles. Yes, I'm gonna set the wide angles for medium. For this setup, maybe low, but anyway, just to keep it simple, we're gonna leave this like this. Use wide angle for intro and outro. I don't know if I need that for this particular case, but use wide angles for silence. I will do that. And then let's see, quality, you can do faster or better. I'm gonna do faster for this particular demo. And you can say use audio analysis for the fastest setup. Now, I'm not gonna do that, and I'm gonna tell you why. The reason why we're not gonna do that is because unlike many of the things that do this type of editing, DaVinci is actually even looking at the clips. It's not just working off the audio side, it's also working off the video side. So it is going to make some intelligent guesses based off of what it sees. So let's pop back over to that baby and see what we see. Okay, so let's get that twisted. Here we go. Go ahead and say analyze. And we're going to see it's starting out at about 60 frames per second. It says it's going to take roughly 5 minutes or so to analyze that clip. But what's cool is it's starting to speed up. I don't think I have much running at the I have a lot running at the time. Let's see what happens if I start to close down some of these other things while it's running to see if it gets any quicker, because this is an M1 Mac Studio. It is relatively fast on its own, but I'm just curious as if DaVinci has more resources to go to town, like how much better can it get? Like that would be super interesting to know. So I closed everything except for Super Whisper, which it doesn't do anything while it's sitting there. Ecamm is running because I'm recording, of course. And then DaVinci Resolve is running. And now it says it's going to take 4 minutes and some chain. So, of course, I'm going to speed this out. But you see the frames are at 108 per second. I don't think it got that much faster. It got a little faster. But I'm going to speed this up and we'll just jump to the end once it's done.
A few moments later.
Okay, as you can see, it's almost done. It only has a few seconds remaining. We'll go ahead and let that finish up. And bingo, just like that, we're done. Let's go and look at the full extent zoom, and you can see all the places where it has decided to make cuts. And if I'm looking at the bottom, it looks like it also switched the audio. I guess that's fine. It's going to get fixed and edited anyway, but I don't think there was a way to make it stick to just one track, but let's zoom in and see how it did. Okay, so of course I'll take this. We want to link the audio and video together. Is it linked now? Yeah, so we're going to start here. Go ahead and let that play. Aloha, creators. You know what it is. Around here, I have a series that I love to do. And let's see if we can bring it to where it made a decision on the first cut. Actually, you can just use the arrow key. See where it decided to make the first cut.
All right, yeah.
No, I'm doing good, man. I'm happy to be a part of this. So let's see what we get into.
Okay, that's actually pretty good. Let's go back up a little bit. And again, I would take this guy, click there, hold the option key and pull it back. No. And then close the gap. Okay, I need to definitely put that on the hotkey. All right, let's do this.
No, I'm doing good, man. I'm happy to be a part of this. So let's see what we get into.
All right, so. All right, it made it a little abrupt right here, but I can spread that out. But you know how it is. I start the same question.
See what we get into.
All right, so you know how it is. I start the session out always with the same question. Luis, what does it mean to you to be a creator today?
Well, what?
Okay, I don't like the way that it did that too fast, but still, this is actually clean. So I can highlight that and then press the shift backspace and then now we're good.
Well, what it means to be a creator for me today is to
let's go and listen to this one. Why you gotta bring, that's actually pretty good. It's only off by a smidgen. Why you gotta bring nephew in right out the gate and try to make me cry when I'm trying to?
You asked me why.
I could have saved that for the end.
You asked me.
Man, that's actually super, super good. That's actually super, super good. Now, of course, I'm not that picky about podcast editing to where I would tighten any of this up. I would kind of just leave it sort of like that.
Why? And he is my purpose.
And then also remember, I could switch over to the cut page real quick, right? And then if I were to make the audio a little wider, I could easily grab that and close it up just a little bit and then switch right back. That's just fast.
You asked me why, and he is.
What's so dope about this? All right. It's actually super good. Let's see where we're doing here. This to me, you know what's so dope about this to me as a person who created this community and then you being one of the first members to join when I decided to do it, to teach them that.
Oh, I like what it did here.
We forget that to teach them that.
All right, you still got to give it some breathing space. It seems it's having a problem with some of my spacing, but...
Maybe you would forget to teach them that.
What is that? Let me find out where it goes.
Maybe you would forget to teach them that.
Oh, I see what it's doing. So what it's doing when it got kind of messed up is it switched from my better quality audio to this one here, which is a little bit lower. Doesn't matter because I'm going to normalize this at the end and it'll kind of fix that. This is probably where I would de-click this and pull the audio from angle 3 maybe or angle 1 where I would want that to be a little bit cleaner. Because angle is me. So let's listen to this.
Maybe you would forget to teach him that. So it's kind of a blessing in disguise. You know what I mean? Our parents, they beat it into us. So nowadays you can't do that.
Oh, I'm curious as to this as well. Hold on. Let me back this up for a second. And let's go back one more. I don't know if this is a possibility, but there is such a thing as replacing this. So I wonder if I decouple. Let's see what happens if I put that. No, that doesn't work. That doesn't work. I thought that might help, but no, it doesn't work. If I switch to that. All right, we'll just keep it going. Never mind. I won't switch. I'll just let it get fixed in the audio in the post.
So it's kind of a blessing in disguise. You know what I mean? Our parents, they beat it into us. So nowadays, you can't do that. So if you knew somebody else to be that dad.
Okay, so let's move this one. Then I could take this whole piece right here. And actually, before I do that, let's move this back. Take this whole piece right here and shift delete.
So if you be that dad. So if you knew somebody else, what?
Oh,
that's pretty cool. I'm gonna back this up again. Then take this piece right here. I don't want to remove too much of the reaction. That's about right there where the reaction starts. So I'll take this out. Shift delete that. Point.
Oh, my advice will always be to just start and do it.
Okay. I'm not gonna make you watch me do this because I did this yesterday. So I'm not gonna make you watch this because you watched me do this yesterday. But I can see where it's gonna save time. Okay, I figured yesterday if I wasn't teaching and I was just chopping, I could do this sort of 20-minute edit in under 10. I think considering the 10 minutes to process it and moving quickly because I kind of know the interview because I did it, I could probably make some quick decisions and chop this up in maybe 5 to 7. But then, of course, I would listen to it again on 2X, which will bring it back to another 10. So, again, 17 minutes, under 30 to finish a podcast edit. I'm going to say this is actually pretty dope. The other thing is if you know that you're going to do this, there would definitely be some liberties I would take in the interview. So, for instance, I would tell my guest to always pause a beat before they answer. I would make it a priority not to try to talk the same time that they're talking because you're going to get it fixed in the edit here. But you don't want to kill the flow too much. And it's super easy to make these minor adjustments when it makes a decision it doesn't like. And that was just using the default settings. I'm sure there's some other settings that we can get in there and tweak and make that situation work any better. Again, you can always replace footage by putting it in its place on top, and actually a pretty dope tool. So if I had to edit a lot of podcasts, I'm doing something that's on a daily basis or just generating a lot of content, I think AI multicam edit is actually pretty sick. And you know what we say around here, I don't know who needs to see this, but if it was you, let me know in the comment section below and I'll get back to it. Now, don't feel bad if you only have the regular version and you don't get to do this. As cool as it is, I don't know if this is the one thing that would make me jump to get the pro version, but if you create a lot and you figure that amount of time is going to save you, if over the course of a month it's going to save you an hour, by goodness, it's absolutely worth getting the full version so that you could get that first chop done with the AI. But from a first chop standpoint, I think it's actually relatively incredible. This is what we used to do in offline editing, where you would take this first chop and just get it done, and you would hand it to a polished editor to come in and finish everything up, tweak it, add the titles, do all that extra sauce. It's very much like that. It's very much like getting that first rough cut done. And for that, I think it's highly valuable. Take this time to hit that like button, hit that subscribe button so you never miss another one of these. We got about 11 more days of DaVinci Resolve 20 over 40 in 30. And right about now, the algorithm is going to show you another video you think you should watch. And I agree with him.
I need to know everything. Who in the what and the where. I need everything. Trust me, I hear what you're saying, but I like it's new what you're telling me. I'm curious, George. I hop in the Porsche, five and a horse. I'm ready for war. I'm coming for throws to turn to a ghost. I need to know everything. Now you'll be surprised at the info you get is by letting them talk, so I'm letting them talk. Gotta keep quiet, maneuver in silence, then let them in talk.